Hello students, today we are going to study the topic stoichiometry of reactions in solutions. Okay, so what is stoichiometry first? In the last class we have studied, it is what? It is a quantitative relationship of the reactants and the products in the chemical reactions. Okay, so in that we have studied about limiting reagent. Now we are moving further with the reactions in the solutions. Okay. So solution, when I am saying, what is a solution? Solution is a homogeneous mixture of two or more chemically non-reacting substances. It is written over here, it is a homogeneous mixture of two or more chemically non-reacting substances. It means it is mixed together without any separation, boundary separation, okay? We can't make out the solute and the solvent in the solution. So what is solute and solvent? Solution consists of what? Solute and solvent. Solute is that which is present in small amount, and solvent is that which is present in the larger amount. For example, if we can take the example of sugar and water, in that if we are taking a glass of water, it is a solvent in which we are adding 2 or 3 teaspoons of sugar. So that sugar is what? The solute. Okay, so here number of solute can be dissolved in the solvent. Okay, there may be two solvent also, but if only one solute and one solvent is present, that is known as what? A binary solution. A binary what? Solution. Okay, when only one solute and one solvent is present, it is known as what? Binary solution. So now we are going to see the expression of concentration of solution. Okay, so first is the mass percentage. What is this mass percentage? Mass percentage is the mass of the solute in grams, present in how much? 100 grams of solution. Okay, so what will be the formula then? So mass percentage of solute is equal to mass of the solute upon the total mass of the solution into 100. Okay, now next is the strength of solution. Strength of solution, this we need in titration. Okay, this is what? This is the amount of solute in grams present per liter solution. Okay, so now the formula of strength of solution becomes what? Mass of the solute in grams upon what? Volume of solution in liters. These all which we are writing, the formulas will be used in what? In calculating while doing the numericals. So in the third, we are studying about what? Mole fraction. Okay, it is the ratio of number of moles of particular component to the total number of moles present in the solution. Okay, so here we are going to consider the moles of solute and solvent. How is number of moles calculated? It is calculated by the formula what? Given mass upon the molar mass. Okay, so here can see N2 and N1 written over here. So what are these N2 and N1? N2 is the number of moles of solute and N1 is the number of moles of what? Solvent. Okay, so what we are going to take out the mole fraction? If we are going to take out the mole fraction of solute, we will be taking what? N2, because N2 is the number of moles of solute, and here we are going to take out the mole fraction of what? Solute. So more number of moles of solute upon number of moles of solvent plus number of moles of solute, this will give the mole fraction of what? Solute. Okay, so now if we want to calculate the mole fraction of solvent, okay, mole which is represented by x1, okay, how we will be calculating? Here we are going to calculate for solvent. So here we will be taking what? Number of moles of solvent upon number of moles of solvent plus number of moles of solute, and we will be getting the mole fraction of what? Solvent. Okay, so here mole fraction of solute and solvent should be equal to 1, and that is considered to be unity. Okay, now the fourth point is the parts per million. Okay, parts per million means million means ppm. Okay, so parts by mass of solute present in million parts by mass of what? Solution. So formula becomes then what? Here we are going to take what? mass of solute present. So mass of solute upon what? Mass of solution into 10 to the power 6. From with this formula we can take out the parts per million, how much solute is present. Okay, so now we are going to study the fifth one, that is the molarity. Okay, so what is molarity? Molarity is the number of moles of solute present in 1 liter of solution. So the formula now, what it will become? Number of moles of solute upon volume of solution in liters. When we are taking in liters, this formula will work. Okay, but if we are taking in milliliters, then how the formula becomes what? Number of moles of solute upon volume of solution in milliliter into 1000. Okay, what molarity is represented by capital M. Okay, so now next, molarity of a solution changes with the temperature, because what happens due to the change in temperature, the volume of the solution changes. So we can't take it as a standard form. Okay, now in laboratory, okay, we prepare the solution of desired concentration. How? We dilute the concentrated solution, isn't it? So when we are diluting the concentrated solution, we can take out the molarity of that solution also by the formula M1 into V1 is equal to M2 into V2. Here M1 and V1, if the solution is having the molarity of what? M1 and volume of V1. Okay, and then what we are doing, the volume V, it is being changed to V2 by while diluting. So if we are knowing V2, V1 and M1, we can calculate the molarity of the solution which we have prepared by the formula M1 into V1 is equal to M2 into V2. So now the sixth we are going to study, the sixth one is what? Molality. So what is molality? Molality is the number of moles of solute present in 1 kg of solvent. So what is the molarity? We have seen with what? Volume. And molality is with mass. Remember that. Okay, so molality is the number of moles of solute present in 1 kg of solvent. Again I am saying, how can we take out the number of moles? Number of moles is the given mass upon the molar mass. With that formula we can take out the number of moles. Okay, so now molality is represented by letter small m. Okay, and the formula now becomes what? As it is number of moles of solute present in 1 kg of solvent, the formula becomes number of moles of solute upon mass of solvent in kg. Okay, if it is not in kg, it is in grams, then the formula becomes moles of solute upon mass of the solvent in grams into what? 1000. Okay, so there, here molality is independent of temperature. Okay, as it involves both the mass of solute and solvent. But molarity, we have seen that it is dependent on temperature. Okay, but this is not dependent on temperature, so this is this, we take it as a standard form. Okay, now next is normality. Okay, what is normality? It is the number of gram equivalents of solute present in per liter of solution. Okay, so the formula of normality becomes now what? Number of gram equivalent of solute upon volume of solution in liters. Okay, so now how to calculate this number of gram equivalent? Its formula is what? To calculate the number of gram equivalent, the formula is mass of the solute in grams upon equivalent mass of the solute in grams. Okay, so now here also, if we are diluting substance, okay, so what happens if its normality is N1 initial, okay, and if its volume is V1, and if we are diluting it to volume V2, we can calculate the normality of the new substance which has been now formed, that is by the formula N1 into V1 is equal to N2 into V2. Here N1, V1 and V2 we are knowing from these figures we can calculate what? N2. Okay, so this is how we can these all the formulas we require for doing the numericals and doing the calculations of the stoichiometry, and it helps in the calculations. Okay, this is all for today. Good day. Take care.